question with your vehicle speeds. If you're trying to simulate as much as possible real life accidents, why your vehicle crash tests rarely go over 40 or 50 miles per hour?
Very often you can brake, slow down the car. So the research that a lot of guys here do from the field, they know that very seldom those accidents occur. Yes,
in comparing the real life crash tests with the computer simulations, is there any one area that differs greatly in real life from the simulations, i.e. the buffers don't react the way you thought, or is there any particular thing or more difficult to simulate than any other?
It's only one thing that I should say. It's sheet metal rupture that we don't cover so far.
Okay.
We cover spot weld rupture and bolt rupture and stuff like that.
So the fenders when they buckle and stuff like that?
No, not the buckle, when they sheet, when they rip the tears. Yes. That's we are not there yet, but maybe in 5 years time or something like that.
We do that on method developments.
Thank you very much.
Also in regards to the correlation between the live and simulated tests, you mentioned comparing vehicle pulse. Can you explain exactly what is vehicle pulse? What does that?
The acceleration of the car.
You have
yes.
Okay.
Or deceleration.
Yeah, right.
Some more questions?
Okay. Well, thank you guys.
Thank you.